Shading is a very important part of drawing. There are four basic shapes: the cone, the sphere, the cylinder, and the cube or the box. Try to find these objects in the plainest version you can around your home and grab them and light them from the side. So we'll start with the cone. Everything is made up of these basic shapes. So if you can master the shading of each of these shapes, then theoretically you will be able to draw anything. So now the cone is lit from one side and the other lights are turned off. The basic shape of the cone is quite simple. You have two equal sides, and the bottom is an ellipse shape. So now you have to identify the shadow. Well, one thing to do before you start is to make a grayscale. Will be my midtone. If you're working with Conte, it's going to be different than if you're working with charcoal. Right now I'm working with Conte. So now I'm making a grayscale. So on the left I'm going to leave a white rectangle, and on the right I'm going to see how dark my Conte will go. So with this Conte I can get it quite black. So this is my darkest and this is my lightest. Then my next one will be a dark gray. Then my middle one. And this will be my lightest gray. So I'm going to make my midtone a bit darker. You want to sort of have equal steps between each one. So there's my white, gray, my mid-tone, my dark gray, and my 100% black. Now when I look at the cone and the shadow, I try to see where is my blackest black. Well, right now it's right between the shadow and the shadow side of the cone. That's usually where you find your darkest darks. So my shadow shape is sort of a triangle. And it's important to get the right angle of your shadow shape. If the angle of the shadow is wrong, then your drawing is wrong. It looks wrong. The shadows have to be as accurate as the object. You can't pretend. The shadows have to be right. My darkest 100% black is right in here, and then this is going to be more like my dark gray. And then as the shadow goes away from the object, the light is dispersed. So there's no really hard edges on the shadow, on the cast shadow. So I'm going to get that in as this gray. And then I'm going to go right in here where it's really dark and put in my 100%. And often you'll see there's not always lines around the object, but you'll often see a line at the base of an object, and I can see a black line there. So I'm going to put that in very carefully. It's quite thin. And then as it goes on the shadow side, it gets a little bit thicker. It's always going to be a bit different, so you have to really use your power of observation. So yeah, so this is my darkest spot. In there. Okay, so when you look at your cone, you see this side is light, and then there's a shadow that goes right down the middle, and then there's a bit of reflected light on this side. It doesn't, in this case, because the object is light and reflective, it doesn't get darker as it goes around here. The darkest part is right there. But it's very graduated. So I'm going to have to be I'm going to break this to make it easier for me. It goes, from my point of view, the darkest part of that shadow goes right down the center. And then it gets lighter and lighter as it goes to the lit side. So I've included all these tones in this drawing, from my 100% black to my dark gray, my mid-tone, my lightest gray, and my white. So all of these are included. So I made the chart, and then I looked for these tones in the object. And I'm going to do this for each object.